So let's start with the boil off arrangement. This gas, liquefied natural gas, is being loaded onto the LNG ships, and the boil off around 1% or something. This is in Ras Lafanor. So mostly you can see this cold liquefied natural gas comes in contact with the warmer ship tanks. 1% of the LNG is evaporated, and you can see like this, it is burnt in the chimney usually, but for environmental purposes, it's not good. So jetty boil off gas presently is burning, but now they have what you call recovery project, where you recover the wasted gas, and it is going into a re-liquefaction plant and is again used. So the jetty can use in the re-liquefaction plant, or you know, the ships also have the re-liquefaction plant. Other thing of using a re-liquefaction plant is in your ship's boiler or main engine. So you can see here the one reason of your boil off is sloshing, like this is a spherical tank and LNG is there inside that tank, and the liquid is sloshing because of the rolling and this thing of the ship. So sloshing is less in a MOS type of tank, which is spherical, so a smoother way, and it is more in prismatic tanks because of the rectangle or triangle shape. So membrane prismatic tank have got more sloshing, and MOS type because of the shape have less sloshing. So you can see the prismatic shape, and because of that, the prismatic shape, the sloshing is much worse. And if you're passing through Cape Horn or Cape of Good Hope, if you have very long waves, you will have a lot of sloshing effect and a lot of boil off. So route planning has to be done as per the, according to the boil off, and you can see that boil off will increase with sloshing speed of the ship and old or odd cargo sizes and area. Then also, if you have partial cargo in the tanks, if tank are not filled, then they have more surface area, more space, so then also it will be more, the boil off will be more. Then the age of the ship, how much is the insulation and all the material, how good is your insulation and the surrounding heat, it will depend. So let's see, we have here what are the main sources of your boil off gas. First is the heat ingress from the surrounding, breaking your insulation, because no insulation is 100% insulation or 100% heat proof. And from the surrounding, whatever heat is exchanged, that will cause the ship to boil off. Then we have the sloshing, which because of the waves or weather, it gives mechanical energy to the system and increases the evaporation because of the turbulence, or you can say a kind of spraying or function, and forms the partial cooling of the tank. Then during the cool down, when you are spraying in the tank, the cold gas which is touching the hot heated tank sides or tank material, then also by heating with getting heated with the hot tank surfaces, there is a lot of boil off, especially during the first 48 hours. Then during loading and discharging, the difference in the pressures, so if there is less pressure, there will be more boil off, and if there is high pressure, there will be less boil off, because the gas will remain in liquid. So especially during loading discharging, if there is a difference between the terminal tank and the ship's tank, then also we will have a more boil off if the pressure in the tank is less. Also, the content of nitrogen will affect the boil off gas. If the cargo has strong content of nitrogen, then the boil off will be increased at the starting of the voyage, as the lighter nitrogen will boil off, and the transfer of LNG by the pumps and valves can be further the source of heat ingress to the LNG as it is transferred. So the decrease in cargo tank pressure is the fifth point, And when the pressure is decreased, the boiling point will change and the gas will evaporate till it reaches its new boiling point. So generally, the maximum what you call boil off rate is between 0.06 to 0.15% of the cargo per day. And during loading and discharging, it is more. So these are the main ways of managing the boil off gas. First thing is we have to load the cargo as cold as possible. Then boil off, when there is generation of boilers, we can do the reliquefaction from the shore or ship side during loading and discharging. And in the sea, the ship can do the, ship is doing the reliquefaction plant. Then to reduce the boil off, we have to maintain the temperature and pressure of the cargo, especially during the loading, discharging, and during the sea also. Then we have to maintain the cargo tank and the interbarrier space on the whole temperature and pressure also. Then it can be used as a fuel in the boiler for creating steam to create the steam turbine. And sometimes people ask that why gas turbine or why LNG cannot be used directly as a fuel, because gas turbines are very expensive and they are like used for very fast engines. And here we have the boiler which is generating steam already. We have the boiler, so slowly it can turn the boiler steam and it can be used. So it is much economical and we don't need that much fast speed here. So steam turbine is more appropriate to be used as here. And then to avoid the sloshing effects, we have to do proper process planning and avoid heavy weather and give a ship the heading so that it's not directly on the beam and it is not too much of rolling and just like that. So this is all about your boil off gas.